I asked the deputy minister, like, what a Gwan ain't like?
I went to church at the cathedral, and then I went to visit people in the hospital, at the Catholic hospital. I usually do it once a month. And on my way, people at my house were breaking, a wall. So we bought some cement on Friday, and then yesterday they called me out of church. They sent a text message, I should call urgently. So then they said, no, they are nearly finished, but they want 3 bags of cement. Can I bring it along? So, and from the cathedral, I went to cash build. It was 12:30. So I went into the shop, I bought 3 cement, and I put it in the car. I think they have a right to be angry because they might have their own reservations and reasonings on this one. But the truth of the matter is that I was given the car that I'm taxed for to use for 24 hours. And that was what I was doing because for me, it's not about that the Mercedes cannot load because the Mercedes is having 1,480 kilogram allowable. So, and I thought that instead of going to the office to get a baki and found this place closed, I can load because it's far below the average or the allowable weight that the car can take. And I usually do it with my own cars. Like, for instance, if I go home because I left my car in Oshibarongo, I can, if I have my mother say, no, bring a bag of salt of 50 kg. I just worried about the kilograms of the car, so I put it on. So, yeah, no, I think they have the right to say, but I think what is not so far fair is that maybe unless the office of the public office bearers, the one that give us the authority to use the cars, whether the Ministry of Works of the Office of the President, just to tell us that, to tell the nation what is the car to be used for. Because today it will be now the cement, and tomorrow it will be a cooler bag, you know, that somebody will say, no, you are not supposed to put it in the car because it's our taxpayers' money. So I actually also very, very much disturbed because people are talking about corruption. Maybe my own understanding of corruption is different. If somebody from Trasco or Coca-Cola as a manager have been given a car by the company to use as part of his package. So he will drop the car at home when he's going to a church or when he's going to a friend's house for a party. He will drop the car at home and just walk to the party. Or what do they expect us, me and others, to do? Even when we came at the school, when my kids are schooling, there was people looking at the car, maybe saying that that is number 81. You know, what is he doing now? Maybe some of them took pictures that I might even see in the social media. So I think I actually, in my own way, I prefer that, like any other parliamentarians, the members of parliament who are not ministers, they are getting a car allowance. They go to the shop, and because they qualify for 9,000, for instance, for their car allowance. So then nobody knows that that car is being paid by the government. But they are loading everything because the car doesn't have a registration number of the government. So if it's an issue, I think that maybe the debate should be opened so that we can maybe get car allowances and buy cars that nobody will know that that is a government vehicle.
She has a point. However, our attempts to get clarity on just what the regulations around the use of government cars from the Ministry of Works and Transport has proved to be a laborious task, and that the ACC can just overlook this, just reaffirms society's lack of faith in them. The Liberian president has cut his own salary because times are tough over there, and our own president, a liker of things just like the rest of us, has smelled the coffee and now flies commercial like the rest of us because the economy is just not what it used to be.